is just one of many legal issues surrounding GoFundMe campaigns that are making news tonight.
Attorney and talk show host Jay Kanzler joining us today to talk about these cases. And Jay, this is an interesting one because we talk about the charges. What kinds of charges could they face?
You know, it would be dependent upon the state. But if this were Missouri, the simple charge would be stealing by deceit. And depending upon the amount of money, and here it's $400,000, clearly it would be a felony. In theory, each donation that was accepted, used for some other purpose other than what it was intended for, would be a separate charge. And here, in these cases, it's really important. What did the campaign organizers say they were going to use the money for? That's critical.
That's a big part of this. Right. This is a new area of law where people are willingly giving their money to a cause without really knowing where it's going. Somebody sets up a page, that sets up all kinds of legal problems, doesn't it?
It does. And, you know, anytime you kind of reach out, you tug at the heartstrings of people, there's the possibility for abuse and fraud. And most people are so generous that they're going to be taken advantage of occasionally.
Mm-hmm. You know, there's this accountability issue. Who is determining where the money is going, the administration of it, because people just donate thinking it's for a good cause.
I mean, if you look at the whole crowdfunding, like a GoFundMe, there are really four players. You have the platform, like GoFundMe. You have the campaign organizer who's putting up the page. You have the donors. And then you possibly have a beneficiary. The platform is just the place where all this goes on, and they're not verifying and they're not guaranteeing that any of these are legitimate. In fact, they're disclaiming it. They're basically saying, donor beware. It's the campaign organizer who, once they get the money, that they are in control. And as we've seen, once they get that money, how it's spent is really hard to track.
I'm going to be very careful talking about this next story here because we're working on a story here. But part of the problem is the lack of accountability. Mm-hmm. There's a situation in our area where the money was raised. Now, one of the parents is out of the way, right? And the kids are back with someone else. And the people who raised the money are over here who raised money for the kids. Kids are here. Parent is gone. Right. Where does that money go? So these people are sitting on a pile of cash that's not going for the kids, even though that's what it was donated for.
You know, once the money's released by GoFundMe, it's gone. So that's it. GoFundMe or other platforms will occasionally, if they suspect fraud, will freeze it. And they'll make the person verify how they're being spending the money. But once it's gone, it's in the hands of the organizer. At that point, it really it becomes very, very murky. You know, if I'm raising money for you out of the goodness of my heart, do you really have a claim against me if I don't give it to
you? So in that case, it would go to the person who had the kids at the time because they raised the money even though they don't have the kids now.
Right, that's exactly right.
You really don't have much recourse is what you're saying.
Not as the person, you know, the person, the homeless person, because really there was no consideration. They did this out of the goodness of their heart. Now, courts hate. They hate it when somebody is taken advantage of, and they can find a way to get the money from the Bobbitts over to the homeless person, but it will be a difficult route.
So, go ahead.
One more Jasmine and I were talking about on Facebook today, which was interesting, is a woman needed a life-saving operation, right? Mm-hmm. Well, that's such a murky area, she used it for plastic surgery. Mm-hmm. When asked about it, she said, well, I was depressed, and it was a life-saving. I needed plastic surgery, so people donated for that.
As I said from the beginning, what did they say they were going to do with the money? Because that's really important. Also, it's important to look, what are they going to do with any leftover money? Oftentimes in these campaigns, they will say, if there is excess money, we will donate it to a charity. We will give it to somebody else who's in a similar position.
She conveniently left out those details.
Hey, life-saving is a subjective term for some people.
So what advice do you have for people then if they, you know, come across a GoFundMe account, they really do want to do good in the community?
I think it's probably be careful. Remember that there are a lot of bad people out there. Do some due diligence, maybe even check with GoFundMe. GoFundMe has these things, that algorithms and so on, that try to detect it. If you suspect fraud, report it. There's a report button on GoFundMe. Hit that button and say, you know what, I'm not sure this is a legitimate campaign.
And again, probably 99.9% of GoFundMes are good. It's these rare cases like this where something gets
murdered. And my clients have
used
it in the past up in Ferguson and other places for great purposes, and I encourage people, don't let a few bad apples make you stop being generous.
All right, Jay Kanzler, you can hear him on the radio tonight, KTRS. What time are you going to be on?
9 to midnight.
All right, Jay, always good to see you. All right, come